Hi students, I hope all you are enjoying electronics video lectures. In last lecture we have studied need of multiplexing and demultiplexing and some examples on multiplexer. As we know that multiplexer has many input and only one output. But demultiplexer has only one input and many output. Okay, in demultiplexer, see this, some applications of demultiplexer as a decoder, means demultiplexer is nearly equal to decoder, but only one exception is there. Let us see. In demultiplexer, single data input is used, which can be sent to one of the output, so that any one output can be made high when data input is high, means we get DI is equal to 1. But in the similar way, decoder circuit, we have also studied decoder circuit. Decoder circuit, it is a circuit which converts given coded information in the BCD form into its equivalent decimal form. So decoder also, we can make any one output to high, that is logic 1, by combination of select input. But this decoder does not have data input like DI in the demultiplexer, means this is a basic difference between decoder and demultiplexer. Both are nearly equals, but except in decoder, there is no data input. Okay, students? So, remember this important point. In decoder circuit, we have the BCD input and that BCD input is converted into its equivalent decimal. Therefore, from above concept, except data input DI, decoder work same that of demultiplexer, but it avoids additional input, that is DI, this data input DI. Let us see some example how demultiplexers and decoders are same except data input DI. In 1:4 demultiplexer, so in this demultiplexer 1:4 can be used as 2:4 or 2:4 decoder except DI, means as this demultiplexer is 1:4, means 2:2 is equal to 4. So there are two select lines. That two select lines are nothing but the input to the decoder 2:4 decoder except data input, that is except this single data input. Let us see next example. As 1:8 demultiplexer requires 3 select lines, therefore we can say that 1:8 demultiplexer can be used as 3:8 decoder except data input, that is a single data input DI. This decoder uses 3-bit BCD coded information and that is given in the form of 3:8 decoder. Then next, 1:16 demultiplexer, means this 16 number denotes that 4 select lines are necessary and that is nothing but 4-bit BCD input to the decoder. So 1:16 demultiplexer can be used as 4:16 decoder except data input. Similarly, at last, 1:32 demultiplexer can be used. 32 means 2:5 is equal to 32. Therefore, this demultiplexer 1:32 demultiplexer can be used as 5:32 decoder except DI. Okay, students. So most important, this number 32 denotes that 5-bit BCD input should be given to the decoder and with the output 32 data output will get at the output of the decoder in the form of decimal information. So therefore, to implement logical operation, we can use decoder instead of demultiplexer accept this data input. So in this way, today we have to learn some different examples related to decoder. Now let's see different examples. Let us see this example. Implement the following Boolean equations by using suitable decoder. Here two Boolean equations are given. Means as I have discussed previously, demultiplexer can be used as a decoder, and that demultiplexer and multiplexer having basic difference. By using multiplexer we can solve only one logical equation, but by using this demultiplexer we can implement more than one logical expression. Okay students, so remember this is most important point. I repeat again, demultiplexers implement more than one logical expressions. So in this equation what is given? F1 is equal to a b c bar d plus a b c d bar plus a b bar c d bar plus a b c d plus a bar b bar c d bar. And then there is a second logical term. This logical expression for F2 is given by the equation F2 is equal to a b bar c bar d bar plus a b plus a bar b bar c bar d plus a bar b c bar d bar plus a bar b bar c d plus a bar b bar c bar d bar. Students, all of you know that as where the bars are present, you can represent that bar with the help of binary zero, and when the real variables are present, we'll replace in the binary form their real digit, that is logic 1. Okay student, so if we have to implement such following Boolean equation by using suitable decoder, then we have to follow step like this. First you have to decide that how many variables are present in the given equation. In this given equation, four variables are present. Which are that? Variable A, B, C, D. Okay. As here four variables are present and we know the equation for select input, that is 2 raised to m is equals to n. Means this m represent the select lines and this n represent the data outputs. So 2 raised to 4 is equal to 16. Means by using this conclusion, we get a clear idea. M is equal to 4, therefore 4 select lines or 4 select input, or these are A, B, C, D are the 4 select input. Okay. As A is at the place of MSB, so it is connected to the S3. N is equal to 16, so we can construct 4 to 16 line decoder. Now we get a clear idea. We have to construct 4 to 16 decoder as by using these 4 variables. But we have to decide from this given equation which are the data lines from the given equation. Okay students, to get this equation from F1, we have to connect the terms given here in this equation to OR gate first. That is, the output F1 will appear at the output of this OR gate. And then another term or logical expression for F2, we have to give the input to the second OR gate and we'll get the output at this second OR gate in the form of F2. Okay student, so we have to decide which input we have to give for these two gates, for F1 and F2 respectively. First we have to write the equation so we can find the output data lines from given equation. F1 is equal to A B C bar D plus A B C D bar plus A B bar C D bar plus A B C D plus A bar B bar C D bar. By writing this logical expression with the help of different logic terms, Now, we have to write equivalent binary code below each term for this first, second, third, fourth, fifth. Okay. So, for this first term, here A, B are present and C bar is there. So, C bar is inactive. C is inactive. Therefore, represent this C with digit 0. Therefore, for data, that is binary data, for first term will be 1 for A, 1 for B, 0 for C bar D, and 1 for D. In the similar way, here A, B, C are present. So, 1, 1, 1 instead of D bar will represent 0. Then A, 1, B bar, 0, C, 1. Then this D bar represented by logic 0 or it is inactive. Now A, B, C, D real variables are there. So you can write here 1, 1, 1, 1. Now A bar, B bar, 0, 0, C, 1, D bar, 0. In this way, after writing all the equivalent binary data, you have to write their equivalent decimal outputs, that is 1101 represent 13 decimals. So here Y output for 13 data line we have to give for this first OR gate. Then second data line for the OR gate will be 111, that is 14. So 14 decimal is the Y 14. Then next 1010 is equivalent to 10 decimal, therefore Y 10 is there. In the similar way, all are 1. This is last input Y 15. This is last output given to the first OR gate. Then 0010 means it represents decimal 2. So it is given from the output to get the equation F 1. Okay, student. Now for F 2. F2 is equals to first term will be A, B bar, C bar, D bar. So A 1, B bar 0, C bar 0, D bar 0 plus A bar, B bar, C bar, D. A bar, B bar, C bar represented by 0, 0, 0 and D is 1. Then next term A bar, B, C bar, D bar. For A bar 0, B 1, C bar 0, D bar 0. Then next A bar 0, B bar 0, C and D 1, 1. Then next term A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar. All are complements are there. Therefore 0, 0, 0, 0. It represent Y 0. After writing all the equivalent binary digits, in similar way like previous equation, that is F 1, we have to write here equivalent decimal output to given for OR gate second. For 1000, this is equivalent to 8 decimal. So Y 8 we have to write here. Then AB, A bar, B bar, C bar, D, 0001 represent decimal 1. Therefore Y 1 is the output given to obtain F 2 from the OR gate second. Now third term 0100 represent decimal 4, therefore this is Y 4. In the similar way 0011 represent Y 3 and at last 0000 represents Y 0. Therefore in this way, in second step we have to write equation, then their equivalent binary digit, then their equivalent decimal output to get or to find the output data lines from the given equation for each OR gate. Okay, students. Thus, to get the first output F1, we have to connect output lines. Output lines for OR gate first, they are Y13, Y14, Y10, Y15, Y2 in this way. Add the input of OR gate to get F1 as an output. Okay, students? I repeat again. To get the first output F1 means to obtain this first F1 equation, this first logical equation for F1, we have to give the data inputs. What are that data inputs? Output lines from the decoder circuit Y13, Y14, Y10, Y15, Y2. Okay, students? Add the input of this OR gate 1. Okay? Now, what will the inputs for OR gate 2 to obtain this F2? Yes. From this equation 2, similarly to get 2nd output F2, we have to connect. So, we have to connect output lines Y8, Y1, Y4, Y3, Y0. Add the input of one OR gate with its output as a F2. Okay, students? Now, let us see. In second step, we have got the terms which we have to give to the each OR gate to obtain F1 and F2. Respectively. In first step, we have got the idea about select lines and these are the output lines. So, S3, S2, S1, S0 are connected to A, B, C, D respectively because instead of S3, S2, S1, S0, A, B, C, D are the four variables given in this equation for F1 and F2. Okay, students? So, in this way, we have to connect A, B, C, D to S3, S2, S1, S0 respectively. As this is 4 line to 16 line decoder, so these are the output lines Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3 up to Y15. Okay, so total outputs are 16. These output lines are connected to for gate 1, this OR gate 1 and OR gate 2 with the help of this equation and that terms are Y13, 14, 10, Y15, Y2 in this way. So, these terms, see, this Y15, Y14, this Y13, then Y10, see here, and this is Y2 is given to OR gate first to obtain the logical equation for F1 with these different terms. In the similar way, output that is Y0, then Y1, Y3, Y4, and at last this Y8 is applied to the second OR gate to obtain the logical equation for F2 with these different terms. Okay, students? And in this way, this strobe input is given to the ground to make enable this decoder circuit. Okay, students, this is most important input. This controls the circuit action, whole circuit action. Okay, so this is called as a enable or strobe input. And positive VCC ground are connected for biasing purpose of this 4 to 16 decoder. Okay, students? So, in this way, by using this equation, first we have to find out how many select lines and how many output data lines and with the help of that, which lines we have to connect to particular OR gate to implement these both equation F1 and F2 respectively. Means, from this example, it is clear that we can construct more than one logical equation with the help of this decoder as compared with the multiplexer. In multiplexer, we can implement only one logical equation, but in this decoder or demultiplexer, we can implement more than one logical expression. Okay, students? Let us see another example. Implement the following multi-output combinational logic circuit using a 4 to 16 line decoder with active low outputs. in this equation, the new word is coming here. Here F1 and summation of M. And here these three words are most important. Active low outputs means we have to give the outputs to each OR gate, but they are active low output. Okay, students? So therefore, in this equation, the terms are given here. F1 is equal to summation of mean terms 1, 3, 6, 7. F2 is equal to summation of M 2, 5, 9, 10. F3 is equal to summation of M 4, 7, 11, 13. While F4 is equal to summation of M 8, 12, 14, 15. As the word active low outputs are given here, we have to give the active low output through this bubble. Okay. But instead of using this OR gate, as we know that the De Morgan's theorem. In De Morgan's theorem, complement of sum is equal to product of the complement. Or simply, we can say that NOR gate is equal to the bubbled AND gate. And when we connect NOT gate to the output of LHS and RHS, then complement of complement is nothing but real variable. Means here complement of NOR is equal to OR. And in the same way, here with this bubbled AND gate, complement is nothing but NAND gate. So from this diagram, we can say that we have to use NAND gates for OR operation. Is that clear, students? So I repeat again, with the help of equation, you can see in this equation, as this is the De Morgan's first theorem, when we apply NOT gate to the output of both LHS as well as RHS, therefore this equation will be turned like this, A plus B bar and bar of the A plus B bar. Then A bar dot B bar and complement of this product. Okay. Then complement of complement will be real variable. So A plus B is there and A bar dot B bar and their complement. So in this way we can say that OR gate can be replaced with the help of bubbled NAND gate. Okay, students. So in this way, if these three words are comes in the equation, that is with active low outputs, if we have to construct 4 to 16 line decoder with the help of active low output, so instead of using simple OR gate, we have to use bubbled NAND gates. Is that clear, students? So as in given equation, you can see 4 to 16 line decoder we have to construct with active low outputs. So 4 select lines are necessary and they are A, B, C, D. They are connected to S3, S2, S1, S0 respectively. Positive VCC and ground supply is given for biasing purpose for this 4 to 16 line decoder. And the most important input besides all these inputs and outputs, called as a strobe input, or this is called as an enable input, this is always connected to the ground to make active this decoder circuit, or this is called as an enable input to make enable this decoder circuit. As we know that we can construct more than one logical equation from the given data. Okay, students, as here four terms are given, F1, F2, F3, F4, all these are four different logical terms, and from this first bracket 1, 3, 6, 7 numbers are present. So we have to connect these terms Y1, Y3, Y6, Y7, and they are colored with blue color. And they are given to the first NAND gate. So this first NAND gate will give F1 as a logical function. So for second bracket, 2, 5, 9, 10 digits are present. So Y2 with green color, Y5, this is second input with green color, then Y9, Y10. In this way, this green color represent the input for second NAND gate that will give output F2 with the help of these input terms. Third NAND gate takes the input from third bracket 4, 7, 11, 13. So, this Y4, Y7 is taken from here with the connection of dot shown here. Then next Y11. Y13, all these four inputs are given to the third NAND gate. So this third NAND gate will give the output F3. At last, with different color shown here, the input for F4 term and the mean terms are 8, 12, 14, 15. Therefore, input to this last NAND gate given with the help of purple color 8, 12, 14, 15. This is Y8, Y12, Y14, and at last this is a Y15 given to the fourth NAND gate, and this NAND gate will give the function logical equation, that is F4. Okay students, so in this way we can connect and we get the output F1, F2, F3, F4 respectively from the NAND gate 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay students, so in this way remember, if the words active low outputs means if we have to construct combinational logic circuit 4 to 16 line decoder with active low output, instead of connecting directly OR gate to this input, because bubbles are used here, so we cannot connect directly OR gate, but this is equivalent to bubble NAND gate. So for that purpose, to take active low inputs, these NAND gates are connected here instead of OR gates. Otherwise, if these words are not present in the given example, so you can connect directly OR gate to the output without these bubbles, but here active low output, so bubbles are used and NAND gates also replace instead of this OR gate. Okay students, so remember that ABCD four input, and these are the given equation, and these are the respected outputs for each and every mean terms for different functions. They are logical functions, okay, and you will get the output F1, F2, F3, F4 finally by constructing this 4 to 16 decoder circuit. Okay students, now in this way, in this chapter number 4, in last part of this video, we have learned different type of examples how to solve with the help of truth table, or with the help of these mean terms, or with the help of logical equation, different type of examples on multiplexers and demultiplexers or decoder. Okay students, in this way you can solve any example given on multiplexer or decoder circuits. Okay student, either in the example logic truth table is given or logical equations are given, you can easily solve any example with the help of the given examples. Okay, students? So, you have to do practice more examples for better performance. Now, today I am giving you assignment on this chapter number 4. This is assignment number 1 from chapter number 4. Implement the following equation by using suitable multiplexer. This question is for 4 marks and the equation is Q is equals to x bar y bar dot z plus x dot y bar dot z plus x y z plus x bar y dot z bar. Question number 2, explain the need of multiplexer and demultiplexer. This question carries 3 marks. Question number 3, implement the expression, this is the given expression, using multiplexer. F of a, b, c, d equals to summation of m into bracket 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Okay. So, student, this is so simple example. You have to implement the given equation in the form of mean terms with 4 variable using multiplexer. This question is for 4 marks. Question number 4. Realize the following truth table using 4:1 multiplexer. What type of logic function will it show? This is a truth table. A, B are the 2 variables while this Y. 0, 0, 0. Second case 0, 1, 1. In third case 1, 0, 1. While in this fourth case 1, 1. Input 1, 1 and output 0. So, in this way, finally we have finished with our chapter number 4. That's it for today's lecture. In next lecture, we'll start with chapter number 4 from paper 1, that is operational amplifier. Thank you.